Horace Mann, an educational philosopher, was most well known for his common school movement, was born in 1796 and he died in 1859. For us to truly understand the contributions to education by Horace Mann, it's best to first understand the cultural context in which he lived. He was situated in a critical time of formation of American identity. Some of the most notable things that were going on in the world at that time was the beginning of industrialization in the United States, an incredible rise of immigration, the westward occupation, most notably the settling of the western frontier. And politically, we saw the beginnings of the abolitionist movement and the women's rights movement. Now, philosophically, he'd been influenced by some of the nation's founding fathers, most notably Thomas Jefferson, Benjamin Franklin, and Noah Webster. Educationally, he was influenced by Pestalozzi, and we see many of the Pestalozzian methods incorporated into the common school practices. Now, philosophically, though, we also see that he was influenced by Jeffersonianism, which is a derivative of Thomas Jefferson's beliefs, and we see also that there are traces of philosophies that were born out of the Enlightenment and the Age of Reason movements, specifically leading him to a transcendentalist view, where he aligned himself with other transcendentalists like Ralph Waldo Emerson and Henry David Thoreau. For us to understand how he arrived at this point, though, it's very beneficial for us to understand the personal beliefs of Horace Mann. He was raised in a religious household where he was arguably indoctrinated with many Calvinistic beliefs. And it's a lot of the morals and ethical values found their way and made their way into the common school fundamental core of curriculum. However, we see that it wasn't long before he converted to Unitarianism, which in essence teaches that all faiths lead to salvation, meaning that really all truth is relative at that point. Now, we also see that he diverged from the traditional teaching of human depravity by evangelical Protestantism, and he believed that human nature was innately good. Not only that, he believed that human nature was malleable, it was plastic. Now, that really was very different than the Jeffersonian vision, which taught that human nature was fixed and there was a certain propensity, and education served to evoke that propensity. Whereas human nature being more malleable, according to Mann, would have really given him reason, with this foundational principle in mind, to provide for equal educational opportunity for all, giving all the opportunity to develop fully. Now, we see that the common school application was meant to be state-sponsored, publicly supported, and managed by democratically elected officials. This was to maintain its integrity, to maintain its sustainability as well. However, we do recognize that the common school movement was incredibly successful in, over the course of 100 years, developing equal educational opportunity for all and transcending not only socioeconomic class, but also race, gender, religion, so forth and so on. This is perhaps the most incredible contribution and accomplishment by any educational philosopher to have ever lived. However, we do see that it's arguably not sustainable due to one major flaw. Well, what's that flaw? The flaw is that Horace Mann chose to only include favorable elements of a biblical worldview, which opened the door to relativism. Relativism is, in essence, a war on absolute truth. It challenges all absolute truth for the sake of an individual's perception of truth over that of absolute truth. Now, a biblical worldview holds to absolute truth, and a part of that absolute truth is that humans are created in the very image of God. In the image of God, there is intrinsic and equal value for all mankind. Whereas relativism teaches that one's individual views are above all other views, making everything unequal simply from a point of perception. Well, unless our public education system corrects course and returns to the acceptance and instruction based on absolute truth, it will not produce a healthy society as man so desired. And the common school movement that was so successful in bringing about equal education opportunity for all will be the very tool that destroys equal opportunity for education.